Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. I am continuing on with the May I Scrap Lift You series, and here's the layout from Hildy. And of course, I will link up all of the other participants as well as Hildy's information so that you can check her out and see what awesome work she does. So I am working with primarily scraps and some older things, so I have done quite a stash dive for this particular layout. And one of the things that I really wanted to highlight today, I'm using this older page from Imagines. It's a map paper, and these are some pictures that we had taken at Pike's Place Market in Seattle last year. And so what I am doing is I am mixing up a variety of different colors and patterns. And I just wanted to encourage you to not be afraid to use different patterns and colors and manufacturers and just everything. So I'm pulling out different colors from my main paper. And one of the things that I do that I think helps to kind of balance the layout is that at the top, I do have a pattern paper, but it's not quite so busy. And so having that up there, also having that brown dotted paper, which is, I believe, Scenic Route, so it's really, really old, at the top and the bottom, as well as this kind of blue kind of in both places, I think it kind of unifies, even if you normally wouldn't put those papers together. So the goal here is to just kind of mix and match and not be afraid to use some extra colors and patterns and just be brave. And so now I'm going to go ahead and put my photos on. I am going to stay pretty close to the original layout. I've got a lot of journaling for this particular one. When we were in Seattle at Pike's Place, there are these pigs there, and I took a picture of it just because I thought it was cool looking. But apparently it has quite a history at Pike's Place Market for doing some fundraising, and I think those little hooves that I had taken a picture of show that. So I wanted to include a lot of that in my journaling. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in this gold die-cut pig that I did and some gold hooves. And I'm going to add those around my layout. I really wanted to bring attention to the pig. And so, you know, and how many layouts do we really get to do where we have a gold pig on there? So I'm going to jump at this opportunity and put those on there. And then I'm going to get really brave again and add in some flowers. I believe they're from Simple Stories. Just adding those to my clusters, just add a little bit more color and a little bit more pop. And I really like how it turned out. And I really encourage you all to be brave with colors and patterns and just, you know, just enjoy it. I think it just adds a little bit of visual interest to your layouts. So here I am adding those floral pieces. This is probably, I am in love with Simple Stories, and so this is definitely not an exception. I love the bright colors, but I think they go okay anyway with the other pattern papers. And yeah, they just sort of look like they were meant to go there. I am going to add that little leaf down at the bottom of my journaling just to kind of tie that into the bottom of the layout so that I have a little bit of a cohesive feeling there. And then I'm going to finish up by trimming off my edges. I do like to pull things off the edge just for a little bit more visual interest and continuity. And then I'm going to do my title with these cute little thickers, and it's just going to say Pike's Place Pig, which isn't terribly creative, but it fits really well over there in the corner, and it uses up some of those letters that I don't normally use. I used a K in there and a lot of P's, and I think it worked out pretty well. I have had these thickers in my stash for quite a while as well, so it was nice to be able to get those used up. So while I'm finishing up my layout, I did want to just remind you to hop along with us. And if you are not yet a subscriber of my channel, I would love to have you join us. We have lots of things coming up. Here's a final layout and some close-ups. Again, thanks so much for stopping by, and I hope that you will also consider subscribing, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye, everyone.